It's a lovely, lovely night.
Yes, it is.
I was hoping you'd bring me here.
I must have read your mind.
I believe you probably could. My, that's a serious look.
Well, it's a pretty serious situation. Every once in a while it hits me. We're doing. Makes me wonder.
And yet.
Oh, I know. It was Dad's idea to take Mother home and for me to drop you off.
It would have been a lot more convenient if you took your mother home, but that's not what he suggested. It has to mean something, Ridge. It must mean something.
Yeah, Logan. It means something.
Well, doesn't it?
Could mean not fully realizing the situation that he's becoming involved with Mother again. That he wants to spend time with her. That he's being drawn back into a marriage of over 30 years. Sure, it could mean all that. That's speculation. It could be something else, too. It could mean that he's just being sensitive, kind, a good man that sees she's hurting and wants to help her through it.
Ridge, they have been through so much together, so many experiences. Why do you think I was so insecure about Eric when it came to Stephanie? Because she was a threat, not an imagined threat. She was a very real threat. She knows Eric better than I ever will, and that counts for a lot. It does. It has to.
Trying to be the prophet of doom here. I want this as much as you do. Maybe you're right. Maybe something is going on with Mother and Dad. Maybe those sparks are being rekindled, but Brooke, I mean, it's...
Shh. Don't say it. Let's just leave it at that, okay?
Can we leave it at that? Can we, Logan?
Again, Macy.
You're asking me if we can be hopeful. I say we can.
We also have to be realistic.
Ridge, hope is realistic. I mean, it's as realistic as anything else in life.
All right.
I convinced you.
You convinced me.
Well, I'll be.
We better get you home before Dad gets there.
Ridge. Here's hoping.
You get home okay?
You mean your father hit any trees? No, he didn't. So what's up?
Just wanted to make sure you're all right.
Why wouldn't I be?
Well, Dad's been the source of a lot of heartache for you lately.
That was several weeks ago.
But you feeling better now?
Yes.
Good, good. Glad to hear that. Any particular reason?
Well, there's always a reason, isn't there?
Hmm? What would that be?
You're very curious.
You're very much my mother.
You're a liar, not a good one. Your curiosity hasn't got a thing to do with the fact that I'm your mother.
So you're gonna answer my question or not?
Well, you already knew the answer to that question before you asked it. Your father has always been a big part of my moods.
That's what I suspected.
That's what you hoped.
So what happened with you two?
Nothing earth-shaking. Your father is a very kind gentleman. He's showing a great deal of concern for me because he doesn't want me to wallow in a lot of pain and despair because of his marriage to Brooke.
But you're feeling encouraged.
Yes, I'm encouraged. Your father's an artist. He's always creating, whether it's consciously or subconsciously. There's a whole part of himself I don't think he's even aware of. The fall collection, next fall's collection, the spring of 95. It's endless, it goes on and on. Consciously, subconsciously. Endless new possibilities. And then there's me. I'm part of that vast subconscious of your father's. I think more than he begins to realize.
Sorry, I'm so late.
That's all right. Did Stephanie have a good time?
Yes, she did. She had a wonderful time. You expecting a cold front through here? How come you're wearing that nightgown?
Is anything wrong with it?
Well, nothing. It just covers too much of it. Here. Put this on for me.
You and Dad must have had one interesting night.
He drove me home, he had a glass of iced tea, and he left.
Did you pick up on anything?
Yes, I think I did. I just hope I'm not misinterpreting something.
I hope not, too.
I want to ask you a question. And I want you to answer me honestly. Was I just too strong and aggressive in our marriage?
Mother, I think that you were dynamic. I think that's why he loved you.
But it didn't work. I think it became too much for him.
No, you know what I think? I think that you two were both victims of success. That everything was fine as long as you were struggling. But once you'd made it, once all those battles had been fought and won, at least most of them, that's when things started becoming anticlimactic for you. Instead of enjoying the fruits of your success, you looked around and you got frightened because there were no more battles to be won. So you created your own battleground. And that turned into your marriage. You both fought. You both lost.
That's pretty depressing.
In this day and age, when we have old enemies becoming new friends and old battles and cold wars being forgotten, maybe you and Dad are right up there with the times because of that.
You think it's possible for impossible dreams to come true?
I think they happen every day.
Well, maybe we're about to witness one.
Are you still alive in there?
Well, that's better. Are you all right?
Of course.
You're not upset about anything?
Now, what would I be upset about?
I don't know. I was just wondering if it bothers you.
What?
Well, times like tonight, when I spend so much time with Stephanie and give her so much of my attention at your expense, of course.
No, that doesn't bother me.
Are you sure?
Eric, I know how much it means to Stephanie. And I'm sure it means a lot to you, too. After all, the both of you were married for over 30 years.
You have become so amazingly understanding about this.
Well, we grow up. You and me, all of us. We grow and we learn. But the important thing is to respond to what we're learning about ourselves, no matter how difficult that is.
Well, you certainly seem to have that lesson down. I hope I can learn it as well.
You will. Just keep in mind that anything is possible, Eric. Nothing is written except for what we ourselves write.
I remember that. I'm going to shower.
Do you love her, Eric?